The immunisation campaign means no child is missed, and that includes going to this slum where 1,000 people live, in the capital of India, Delhi. Now, we've just come to visit this family who live here. This lady has 4 children who are aged 7, 6, 4 and 1. So the 3 youngest in particular are at great risk. So why did she come to the slums?
Because her husband works here, so she has come here for the last 1 year.
This is such a high risk area. I mean, I don't know if you can see, but there's flies absolutely everywhere. And what happens here is people sort through the rubbish, don't they, to find things to recycle?
Yeah, but you recycle, yeah, that's right. The rubbish comes here, they recycle it, they sell it to live their life.
Yeah, so where do they sleep?
Where do they sleep? Achha, this is the hut they sleep inside this hut.
So the kitchen's just there, and look at all this rubbish and flies just around the kitchen area. This area is so high risk. It's probably one of the most high risk areas, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, that's right.
Hello. Hello. There's so many little children everywhere, sort of crawling in between flies. And if you look down, there's just like mud and poo and cows and rubbish, sacks of rubbish, because obviously they sort through rubbish here. And it is really, really smelly. You can just smell feces in the air. I mean, just look at all these flies, they're all on buckets and utensils. You know, you can see how something like polio would be spread so easily in an area like this. As far as polio is concerned, most hospitals don't see it as urgent. They often have beds filled up by patients who have been in road traffic incidents or maybe need urgent surgery to save their lives. So hospitals often turn away polio sufferers. And not only that, private hospitals know they can't earn money from polio sufferers because it's a disease that affects the poor. So often, polio sufferers don't get any medical treatment at all. But here at St. Stephen's Hospital, there's a ward that's been specially reserved just for victims of polio.
Salman is 13 years old, and he's suffered from polio when he was 1 year of age.
So has Salman not been able to walk at all since he was born?
No, he has not been able to walk. When he came to us, he was just crawling on his four limbs, and he had deformity in the right lower limb, with the knee being bent, and also a deformity in the hip. So what we have done is that we have corrected the deformity of the hip by a surgery, and we have corrected the deformity of the knee again by a surgery, and we have fitted him with a caliper so that now he can walk straight on his both lower limbs, something which he was not able to do before. Rest of her children are going to school. She's saying he previously, because he could not walk, he was not going to school. Now she's going to send him to the school. He's saying he used to fall again and again, and he had to crawl on the floor to go from one place to the other. Now he's able to walk, and he no longer needs to crawl.
Since 1985, when Rotary pledged to immunise all the world's children against polio, it has been working with the World Health Organisation, United Nations Children's Fund, UNICEF, and the US Centres for Disease Control and Prevention to do just that. So how near is a polio-free India and a polio-free world?
At the beginning of the programme, there was no place in India that was polio-free. More than 99% of the job has been done. But there's still a long way to go, because the last few miles are the most difficult. And I expect that since the virus is hiding in these last bastions, it won't be long before we actually win.
As long as one case of polio remains in the world, no child is safe from this deadly disease, which could be just a flight away. So how can you help to rid the world of polio? In the Rotary Thanks for Life End Polio Now campaign, every pound raised will be used to save the lives of 5 children by preventing them from getting polio. Schools can hold fundraising events, for example Purple Pinky Days, when everyone dresses in purple, named after the purple dye put on the children's little fingers to show that they have been immunised. Rotary clubs in Britain and Ireland are here to help schools get involved in this campaign. To find out more, contact your local Rotary club or go to the website www.thanksforlife.org.